So, I'm pretty excited for Crash 4, but I mean, can you blame me? It's one of my most anticipated games of the year. I mean, with more interviews, more screenshots, and more gameplay footage, I mean, this is hyping up to be one of, if not one of the best Crash Bandicoot games of all time. So once I heard that Crash 4 was finally gonna get a demo, I was really excited. However, there was one simple problem. That's a yikes for me, dog. From a business perspective, I could definitely see why they did this, but like, it defeats the point of a demo. At its core, a demo is a test to show the audience what the game is all about and to see if they want to buy the product or not. I don't think this was Toys for Bob's decision, rather I think it was Activision's, since they did the same shit with the Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 and 2 remake. So as much as it pained me, I wasn't really gonna get the game digitally since I was already gonna get it physically. So there really was no point in buying it digitally just to play the demo. Until, in one fateful day, Mr. Matt Danenvik on Twitter said, "Yo, small content creators, y'all wanna play the Crash 4 demo early and free?" And I'm like, "Yo, hit me up." He's like, "All right, here's the code." I'm like, "Yo, what the fuck?" So yeah, as much as I don't want to flex, I got the Crash 4 demo early and free. Who knew? And yes, I got it in September 14, and I know a lot of you are going to be asking, so why did you wait so long to make a video on it? Well, that's because I decided to play it in more ways than one. I decided to play it casually, I decided to complete it 100%, I decided to do it normally, and then I decided to speedrun it because why the hell not? I did it on both modern and retro, and what are my thoughts on it? Well, let's talk about it. But first, I do want to address some stuff. Number one, I would like to once again thank Activision and Matt Danenvik on Twitter for sending me a review code for the demo. Without them, I wouldn't be making this video. And number two, and most importantly, this is only a demo, so some of my criticisms might not be subjective to the final product. So with all that being said, let's review the Crash 4 demo.
General criticism.
Crash 4 is beautiful. I mean, these are from the guys who created the Spyro Reignited trilogy, so already my expectations were high. But goddamn, I did not expect them to be this beautiful. The character, the models, the animation, the expressiveness, and the backgrounds. Everything is brimming with personality, so much that I absolutely love it. Seriously, this game has so much personality and wits that it's almost ridiculous. It actually reminds me a lot of the Looney Tunes cartoons, and that's obviously not an insult because I really like those cartoons. Next up we have the gameplay, which is something I was sorta worried about since a lot of the Crash YouTubers who got to play the demo early were saying that the controls were good, but definitely a downside. I'm definitely one of those players that focus more on the gameplay than really the, what's it called, the story. Because I go by a rule, if it's not fun, why bother? So I can definitely say without a doubt that I really think the controls in this game are really good. Hell, I would even say they're better than the N'Sane trilogy. I already like the controls in the N'Sane trilogy. Yeah, that's right, I said it. I really like the N'Sane trilogy's controls. Don't judge me. But with that being said, there are some downsides to the controls. That being the sliding and the slide jumps. Oh god, like, I think that slide jumping with, like, the spin attack and jumping is definitely one of the most useful things to do in a Crash game. And it's kind of weird that they nerfed it for no reason. But, like I said, this is a demo and it's probably going to be changed. With this demo is definitely different from the one that the critics played it, since a lot of the critics are saying that the slide jump was fixed with this one. So who knows. Also really like the music. I think it's really catchy. One of my favorites is Shit Happens, and the voice acting is also really good. I think that they changed Coco's voice actress. I think they also did this with Crash, but I'm not really sure. So overall, some of the general stuff in the game is pretty good. So let's get going with the levels.
Levels!
Snow Way Out is fun. Like, they actually made an ice level to be really fun. I don't know how they managed to do it, but they actually did it. So in this level, they introduced the Time Mask Kapunawa. I think this is a great introduction to her moveset. to the whole entire time stopping thing. I really think it's a good level. It's also really fun. So I think the physics are good. I think like the whole entire time mechanic is also really done pretty well. I like the bonus stage. It's an overall great around level. Next up we have Dino Dash, and I suck at this one. I really, really suck at this one. Like, it's so hard to the whole entire, you know, trying to stay alive thing. Like, there's so many things against you, especially those fucking acid spitting plants. This level also introduces Lanny Loli, I think his name was, the shape-shifting mask, which like takes things out of the universe and then puts other things. I think it's a good mask, although it was pretty hard to do when it also introduces another mechanic with grinding. And I died like three times, or like I think even more, trying to grind, like trying to learn it, until I figured out you had to use the O button to grind. I think it's a pretty hard mechanic, and I don't think this is the introductory level to both of those things. I think there needs to be a better tutorial for them. And then we have this chase scene, which I think is probably the best chase scene in the entire series, because it actually makes you, like, it keeps you entertained, like, it keeps you on your toes and stuff. Like, you have to be really careful to be staying alive in this part, and I really found it so satisfying to finally see that fucking T-Rex die. And then we have Ship Happens. Oh yeah, right, there's multiple characters in this game. Cortex is really satisfying to use. I was kind of worried to see how they would do with him, and I think they did him a pretty good job. Like the character himself, you have to think more with your brains. So I think the game, like his whole entire shtick, is pretty good. Although one downside I do have with Ship Happens is that almost half of the level you get to play as Cortex, and then you get to play as Crash again in Snow Way Out, but a bit harder. I hope that levels of like the different characters are just more like have the more like extended actual original levels than just timeline versions. I mean, it's good, but like I wish they were like full levels for the alternate characters, but that's just how I see it. Also, I really like, also with the criticism out of the way, I really like this level. It's probably my favorite level in the entire demo. So overall, the selection of levels are not half bad. I think are really good. Also, if you were to ask me what my, I don't know, what the hardest to least hardest level is, I would definitely say that Dino Dash is definitely the hardest level in the demo. Such a pain in the ass, but I still enjoyed it. Then we have Ship Happens, which is like a harder version of Snow Way Out. And then the easiest level is Snow Way Out. At first it might be tricky, but then after that it gets pretty easy. So overall, the Crash 4 demo was absolutely great. The music, the animation, everything about it just screams personality, and I absolutely loved it. So if you came to this video to see if you can get the demo or not, well, that's up to you, buddy. If you think of getting the game digitally, then I highly recommend getting the demo now so you can play it. But if you want to buy the game physically, then I recommend waiting until the game officially comes out. I mean, by the time I'm making this video, it's going to be like 7 days, 1 week before Crash Bandicoot 4 comes out. So I think we can wait a little bit more. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, please consider liking and subscribing. Hell, why not even share it with other people? Consider following my Twitter and join my Discord server so you can hang out with me and other people. Anyway, that's all for now. Have a nice day, everybody.
Hi, I'm Dan. You know, from the Dan the Man Show. Anyway, you might know me from such videos like The Worst Game Show Ever and Yoshi's 25th Birthday. Oh, for fuck's sake, Manuel, you really had to bring that one up. This video is a collaboration between both of us, and I highly recommend checking out my video on the demo. The link to the video and my YouTube channel will be in the description below.